Hello, we're at the Turning Stone Casino in Verona, New York, where Lone Star is playing a show here tonight. It's a beautiful showroom, got a great stage, perfect show, or perfect place to do a gear rundown. So that's what I'm going to do. First, we're going to go to the new thing, because that's what kind of everybody's asking about. So this little green toaster box, that's what I'm using now for a guitar rig. All this other stuff is kind of peripheral. Not that it's not important, but that's all the sounds coming out of that. So what it does basically is I've stored all my own amps profiles into it. So I've spent a lot of time profiling my own amps and getting them in there. So now at any song or any point in the show, I want to use a certain one of my amps for a song. I just call up that preset, edit the effects for it, and boom, I've got that sound right at my fingertips. So it's called the Kemper Profiling Amplifier. So that's what I'm using. All this over here is just for monitoring purposes. I run direct out of the Kemper to the front of the house, and then I've got a separate monitor out to the back of this, which I'm just using for the power amp and speakers, so I can just kind of hear myself on stage. So, the Kemper's cool. It's got all the effects and everything built in it. Like I said, you can get to everything super duper quick. I use the MIDI pedal board. The pedal board's not quite as sexy as it used to be because all the boutique pedals are gone, and all I have is a MIDI controller, a MIDI expression pedal, and a tuner. The tuner is just coming straight out of an auxiliary output of the wireless, and the tap tempo, if I have any delay patches that don't already have delay times, I can tap the tempo of the delay in. So that's pretty much it. And for the show, I just start down low on the banks and work my way up. So I've got bank up and go to the next song. You can see the song names are on there. That's pretty much it. All the sounds to me have been working really well. I've used this rig for about almost, I guess about a year and a half now, and so far it's been pretty flawless. All I have in the rack are wireless units for my vocal mic and for my guitar. The wireless goes straight into this, and like I said, direct out to the front of house and monitor out to the amp. So let's get started. Let's listen to sounds. And I'm running the audio from my in-ear wireless pack into, so that's what you'll be hearing. So it's not just an ambient room mic. You're actually hearing what I'm hearing when I'm on stage in my in-ear pack. First, the cool thing about the Kemper too is you can get super duper clean sounds, and they're just as loud as your gain sounds, which with a traditional rig it's kind of hard to do that. And another cool thing is I can get different sounding cleans. I want a Princeton clean or divided by 13 clean sound, or a 68 Deluxe. Or my trusty third power that I use most of the night. And then I've got all my mid-gain sounds. Usually those are the third power amp profiles, and I've got either a Timmy pedal or a Klon with them. Those are things kind of like this. Also with this MIDI pedal setup, I can make this expression pedal anything I want it to be. Most of the time it's volume. So for most of the show, it's just my volume control. I do have an instance where I need it for something else. I can make it, for instance, on this patch, I've got it set for a whammy pedal. So it's just really versatile. I can kind of make it a wah-wah pedal if I want it. Most of the time it's just a volume pedal. That's the whammy pedal patch is the only one that I do something different on. Also want to show you the harmony patches as well. So. I'm in the wrong key, so it's... Anyway, the harmonies in here are pretty cool, the harmony presets. So I use that one on one song. And then, the rotary thing would be... Thank you. I've got that, and I've also got like obligatory rock medley stuff. And then my octones. Everything, and I just kind of increase them in gain as they go up. So that's the nuts and bolts of the rigs. Come over here and I'll show you some guitars. So as far as guitars go, what I'm taking on the road, I've got a couple Tommy Andersons and a Nags. This is my main guitar. We call it number one, or red. Beautiful guitar. It's got Duncan Antiquity pickups. I've had this thing for over 12 years now, I guess. It's got the drop D detuner on it, tremolo and all that good stuff. And that's my main guitar. And I recently just got a new Nags guitar. This is Chris. He's my guitar tech. Say hi, Chris. Hi, Chris. The Nags guitar, beautiful guitar. It's kind of like a Les Paul, but its body is really contoured and it's not super duper thick. Man, it's got a nice big 59 neck profile on it. The pickups are super nice and bright and clear for humbuckers. I usually have a hard time using humbuckers on the road, but these have such a clarity that fits right in with my P90s and my Tellys. So that's that one. And then I've got one more, my latest Anderson. It is just a two pickup model of the Cobra, kind of like the other one, but it's only got two pickups. These are also Duncan. These are custom shop Duncans with Alnico 5 magnets. They were a little bit brighter, a little bit more like a Tele. This body is super duper light. It's gorgeous mahogany. So that's really my sounds. Like I said, most of my profiles are the third power amp. I do have a couple of the EVH. I've got a couple of Fenders in there. So the cool thing about the Kemper is just you can store so many different amp sounds and you have them at your disposal and they're all kind of uniform and you can use them for whatever. Up here on this top row you can see these are the effects before the amp. This is the amp section. These are the effects after the amp. So usually I don't have much on. There's nothing really on right now. Delays, if I want to turn off the delay, just hit the button. Oops, hit the button, it's off. Hit a button, it's on. There's reverb. Oh, another cool thing I do when I'm running it is I dedicate this knob and you can set it so this master volume controls whatever you want. I've got it just controlling the send to this amp. So if during a show I just need more stage volume, I can turn it up here. And you can see it kind of goes up and I get more stage volume and it doesn't affect the front of house, monitors, anybody else. So that's my rig. This is the 2014 guitar rig for Michael Bird Lone Star. Thanks for watching.